not much to say about Gamma Sinatra, except it was written in 1916. It was my third work. At the time, I was working full-time in technical library at the Commonwealth Department of Works, Architecture and Engineering Design, Branch, one-person library, which is no longer on the corner of Lonsdale and Exhibition Street. It had been played at George Strauss's Music Ensemble concert by Margaret Schofield, and I was going overseas in 1962 for a year, and it was important to have a tape of one of my works to take, and this was the only hope. So Margaret was very good and got a broadcast, which gave me a real little tape, which I could take. Because scores are really very good at giving people an idea of what your music sounds like when you're turning it around. And the first person I showed it to, or who was able to play it, and here it was Noel Banks, who was very good to me when I went over there. It just happened to be also the first time the IFCN, the whole body met in London, the first time in 16 years. The IFCN had been going since the early 1920s. That being the International Society of Contemporary Music. And that was very exciting, attending that and meeting a lot of European continental composers as well as English composers. And then again later, Donald Valbanks drove me around the Edinburgh Festival, and I met a lot more composers because of Donald's great assistance. But having that tape gave me the credentials as a composer, because I've only written three works. And the tape of the piano sonata, I then later took over to Holland when I went to Bilthoven and the electronic music school there in September. And to Paris for 3 weeks when I was. So I've still got that old 7.5 feet tape. I'm not sure what condition it's in. And that's about all I think I can say about the work. There's some rather dark facts in the background. That's the background. Thank you.